Now remember, HIV in pregnancy, just a few important things which you should know are that it is an RNA virus and the prevalence in pregnant women is around 0.3%. Hi students, let us discuss now a very important infection in pregnancy, that is HIV in pregnancy. So the keywords we will be dealing with are HIV, heart, vertical transmission and CD4 count. Let's start with a case scenario. A 24-year-old primary gravida presents to the OPD for a routine ANC at 8 weeks. She tests positive for HIV. Her CD4 count is 450. How will you manage this pregnancy? Now remember, HIV in pregnancy, just a few important things which you should know before we go into more detail are that it is an RNA virus and the prevalence in pregnant women is around 0.3%. And very important to know that we know that the routes of transmission are either through blood or sexual transmission, but very important in pregnancy, the route of transmission which we are most worried about is vertical transmission, that is from mother to baby. And if we don't give any treatment, if we don't do anything, there is a 30% chance that her fetus will develop the infection if the mother is HIV positive. That's why it's very essential. This topic becomes very important because our main aim now is to prevent vertical transmission. Okay, so we all know the risk factors of HIV and the modes of transmission, but we will concentrate mainly on preventing vertical transmission. So vertical transmission, we can classify it, subclassify it into when it's the antepartum period, the intrapartum period and the postpartum period. The intrapartum period, that is during labor, is when she is at highest risk of transmitting the infection to the fetus. Antepartum, it is around 20% risk. Intrapartum, it is as high as 60% the chance of vertical transmission, and postpartum, it is around 30%. By giving highly active antiretroviral therapy or antiretroviral therapy, we can reduce this risk to as low as even 1%. So this is why starting heart is very essential in pregnant women who are HIV positive, because we significantly reduce the risk of vertical transmission from 30% to 1%. And that is why this topic is so important. And I will repeat again, the risk of transmission is highest in the intrapartum period compared to the antepartum or the postpartum period. Now, what are the risk factors for vertical transmission? Some women are at a higher risk of vertical transmission. Those who have a high viremia or a lower CD4 count, that means their immunity is less, they are at a higher risk of transmitting the virus to their babies. So high viremia, low CD4, the presence of additional sexually transmitted infection. If you're doing an invasive procedure in pregnancy like an amniocentesis or an external cephalic version, that also increases the risk of vertical transmission to the fetus. If the woman has rupture of membranes, premature rupture of membranes or preterm pre-labor rupture of membranes, if we're performing an operative delivery, if we're even giving an episiotomy or a forceps or a vacuum, all these increase the risk of vertical transmission. Any concurrent infection also increases the risk of vertical transmission. If the baby's preterm, if we are using invasive fetal monitoring, which we usually don't, but this is also a risk factor, and postpartum, if the baby is on mixed feeding, these are also increased risk factors for vertical transmission. So before a woman conceives, and if she knows her HIV status during preconceptional counseling, then we can start discussing the options that she has preconception itself. So what are the we can discuss reproductive options for her. Okay, so what could be done is, if she's planning to conceive, then IUI can be advised, avoiding barrier contraception only during her fertile period if she wants to conceive. So discussing different reproductive options can be discussed. Optimizing HIV management in the woman should be discussed. If she's already on antiretroviral therapy, what should be done when she becomes pregnant? Or if she's not on therapy, when should she start antiretroviral therapy during pregnancy? All these are points to be discussed in the preconceptional counseling, that is timing of initiation of ART. What is her risk of infection? Is she updated regarding her immunization? If not, then she needs to first complete her immunization before embarking on pregnancy. Psychological support is very, very important in such women. And of course, safe sexual practices need to be emphasized. Now, when a woman gets pregnant, HIV testing is part of the initial screening tests which we do in the antenatal period, along with hepatitis B, HIV and VDRL for syphilis. These are the three infections we mainly test for in all pregnant women once they come to us in the first trimester. So it is part of routine antenatal testing. And NACO. NACO is what the National AIDS Control Organization recommends, opt-out approach. That means you explain to her, we are going to do these tests, and she can choose to opt out. She can choose to refuse, but we will offer it to her and then she can opt out. So this is what the NACO recommends for our country. This is the opt-out approach. Okay, so what do we use for screening? We use the ELISA test for screening, and if the test is positive by ELISA, we confirm by Western blot or immunofluorescence. So if she's HIV positive, what is the antepartum management? It is a multidisciplinary team approach. The physician has to be involved, social services, psychiatrist, everybody has to be involved in her treatment. What are the investigations we advise? We advise in HIV, the viremia, the level of viremia has to be seen. So the viral load is done, CD4 count is repeated every trimester, CBC is done, urine routine microscopy to look for asymptomatic bacteriuria, test for sexually transmitted diseases, test for toxoplasmosis and cytomegalovirus, screening for tuberculosis and liver function test. These are part of routine screening in the antepartum period. Counsel her regarding the risk of vertical transmission. Tell her that she's at risk, the baby is at risk, especially in the intrapartum period, and this risk can be reduced by starting her antiretroviral therapy. She may request MTP, especially if it is severe disease, or she may herself request on demand an MTP. Nutritional advice has to be given. Avoid invasive testing like amniocentesis or CVS. This increases the risk of vertical transmission. And very, very important, she needs to be started on antiretroviral therapy. And once started on antiretroviral therapy, please remember, in pregnancy, this has to be continued then lifelong. Okay, so this is the recent guidelines. What NACO says is option B plus. What does option B plus say for pregnant women? Regardless of the CT4 count or regardless of the stage of disease, initiate ART and continue it beyond pregnancy. So initiate and maintain for all pregnant women. So once they're pregnant, initiate ART and continue it lifelong is the new protocol as per NACO guidelines. So heart reduces the transmission to less than 2%, and as per NACO, initiate lifelong ART in all pregnant women with confirmed HIV infection. What is the ART we give? We give tenofovir plus lamivudine plus efavirenz. These three drugs is what is the standard protocol of HIV, treating HIV in pregnancy. Tenofovir plus lamivudine plus efavirenz. And pregnant woman detected to be HIV positive for the first time in labor. So say a woman comes to you, she's completely unbooked, no investigations. Many times we get such patients. And when we test, do their viral markers, test for HIV, when she comes in labor, she's found to be positive. What do we do then? We start this regime during labor. When she comes to us intrapartum, we start her on tenofovir plus lamivudine plus efavirenz. And if the woman was on ART prior to conception, this is the third scenario, she was already taking ART prior to conceiving, then what do? We continue the same drugs or the same regime she was on is continued in pregnancy. Intrapartum, what are the guidelines? So both the WHO and NACO say that cesarean section is to be done only for obstetric indication. Okay, I will repeat, cesarean section, elective cesarean section, only for obstetric indication. We should not be doing routine cesareans for HIV positive women is what WHO and NACO says. Although cesarean section does reduce the transmission by 50%, but still to avoid unnecessary cesareans, what NACO and WHO says that if you're giving heart, there's no additional benefit by doing a cesarean section. So cesarean is reserved only for obstetric indications. But the RCOG and ACOG both say elective LSAS at 38 weeks is recommended for those women. But if they have a very low viral load, then you can allow them to have a vaginal delivery. But if they have high viral loads, then elective LSAS for all women at 38 weeks. But our country, our guidelines, WHO guidelines, NACO guidelines say cesarean section only for obstetric indication, not just because she is HIV positive. So please remember this. Okay. Factors increasing the risk of transmission if she ruptures her membranes and then delivers very long afterwards. So long rupture of membrane to delivery interval. If you're doing invasive fetal monitoring, episiotomy, giving an episiotomy or using an instrument to deliver her can cause trauma and hence transmission, risk of transmission increases. Please remember universal precautions to be used by all when dealing with such patients during delivery. Postpartum management, breastfeeding increases the transmission rate, but mixed feeding is even worse. So NACO and WHO both say that exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months is to be given in HIV positive women, or if you're not giving exclusive feeding, the risk of transmission mixed feeding is even worse. So exclusive feeding is recommended. Exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months is the recommendation by both WHO and NACO, but breastfeeding does increase the transmission, but not as much as mixed feeding. So if you're breastfeeding, it has to be exclusive breastfeeding. That's very important to remember. To the neonate, ART is given nevirapine 2 mg per kg from birth for 6 weeks or zidovudine 4 mg per kg BD for 6 weeks is given till the baby status is known. So let's recap, what is the risk of vertical transmission in HIV in pregnancy? There is almost a 30% risk. In the antepartum period, it's around 20%. In the intrapartum period, it's around 50 to 60%. And in the postpartum period, it's around 30%. This can be reduced to 1 to 2% by giving highly active antiretroviral therapy. Preconception counseling is very important because the woman can make an informed decision about whether she wants to become pregnant or not. What are the things which will be involved? How will she continue her ART? What are the different aspects involved? Her immunization needs to be updated. So everything will be covered in preconception counseling. However, if she gets to know that she is HIV positive during pregnancy, and that is usually done as part of routine antenatal screening, then antenatal management involves getting a viral load done, getting a CD4 count done, starting her on antiretroviral therapy, treating her for infections, treating her for anemia, giving her good diet and nutritional supplements. So ART, that is highly active antiretroviral therapy, started during pregnancy, and this is the WHO NACO guidelines say you have to start it in pregnancy and then continue lifelong. Very important, start in pregnancy and continue lifelong. And what is given? We give tenofovir plus lamivudine plus efavirenz. If the woman comes to us for the first time in labor and she's HIV positive, we start this regime during labor. Okay, so intrapartum management, what is important to remember? You can start this regime during labor if she's not been taking it previously. Elective cesarean section or cesarean section only for obstetric indication. All right, and if intrapartum, avoid episiotomy, avoid instrumental deliveries, and avoid a prolonged rupture of membrane to delivery interval. Postpartum management, ART is continued for the woman. The baby also receives either nevirapine or zidovudine. Okay, and the woman is advised appropriate contraception. Let's do some MCQs on HIV in pregnancy. With the use of antiretroviral therapy and scheduled cesarean delivery, the perinatal transmission of HIV has reduced from 30% to, and the answer is 1%. So with antiretroviral therapy itself, the transmission has reduced drastically. Next question. All are risk factors for increased perinatal transmission of HIV except. So invasive fetal monitoring is a risk factor. high viral load is a risk factor. Presence of infection, chorioamnionitis, is a risk factor, but not a high CD4, but a low CD4 count is a risk factor. So this is the wrong answer. The correct answer, sorry. In the absence of ART, the risk of perinatal transmission of HIV before 36 weeks pregnancy. So they're asking in the antepartum period. So remember, antepartum period, the risk of transmission is about 20%, in the intrapartum period it's about 60%, and in the postpartum period it is about 30%. The NACO recommends which of the following screening approaches for HIV testing in pregnancy in India? Is it the opt-in approach, the opt-out approach, screening in high-risk groups, or compulsory screening? And we have opted for, NACO has opted for opt-out screening for our country. A 21-year-old primary presents to the antenatal clinic for routine checkups. On investigation, she is found to be HIV positive. Her CD4 count is 500. What is the best management option? Start ART and continue lifelong. Start ART in the third trimester and continue lifelong. Do not start ART till the CD4 count is less than 200. Start ART and continue till breastfeeding is stopped. The answer is start ART and continue lifelong. So please remember, in pregnancy, if HIV is detected, start her on antiretroviral therapy, and this needs to be continued lifelong. The last question is, a 30-year-old G2P1L1 presents to the labor room at 38 weeks. She is an unbooked patient, and on routine investigations, she is found to be HIV positive. What is the next best step in management? Will you administer tocolysis and send a CT4 count? Conduct delivery with universal precautions, initiate ART, or do an immediate cesarean section? So she's unbooked and she's found to be HIV positive. What is the first thing you'll do? You'll initiate antiretroviral therapy. All right. So this is about this topic. It's a very small topic. It's a very important infection in pregnancy. Docemy.